Je vous souhaite la bienvenue à cette célébration de l'amour entre Andrea et Dan. So, welcome to an event years in the making. Let me hear you now. Are you ready for them to finally get married? On their behalf, welcome and thank you for being here at this celebration of their love for one another. They've asked each of you to witness and celebrate this public declaration of the private commitment they've already made to one another. 17 years ago, they started their life's journey together. During the ensuing years, they shared many life experiences. Their circle of friends grew and strengthened. They learned to love deeply and unconditionally, and they discovered a reassuring strength in one another's arms. The fact that all of you have come from far and wide to be here today is a testament to the amazing amount of love and support that they have. Andrea and Dan stand now before those who love them, those whom they love, those that have raised them, taught them, supported them, shaped them, and given them much happiness, warmth, and guidance through the various stages of their lives. Since language often fails emotion, they say simply and sincerely, thank you all for being here to celebrate their big day. Now they've come together to learn the best of what each has to offer, appreciating their differences, indeed strengthened by them, and confirming that being together is far better than being apart from one another. They chose this specific location for their wedding ceremony because they want the celebration of their marriage to be casual and fun, unique with traditions, and to share with you a day of memories that will be with them for a lifetime. Now today, tonight, it's not just about them, because each of you has given something special to their lives, and that contribution will forever be appreciated. They want you to enjoy their company, each other's company, and to have good food and drink tonight. And at this time, they've asked me to acknowledge all those other loved ones who could not be present to share in their joy, but who are with them in heart, mind, and spirit, and whom we are certain also celebrate with them. As well, on their behalf, they've asked me to thank their parents. Elizabeth, Marcel, Kathleen, Theodore, and Catherine for giving their support for this marriage. They've learned many things from their parents whose love, support, and nurturing is such an essential part of who they are today. They thank you for being their first teachers of the powers and possibilities of love. And it's from you that they've learned the true meaning of love, friendship, and family. And I think their parents deserve a round of applause for the great job that they've done. Today is a celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, of family, and of two people who are in it forever. You don't have to have a ceremony to have a marriage, and when you think about it, the whole thing is kind of weird. You're standing on a stage looking fancy, holding flowers, and being stared at by practically everybody who's meant something to you in the past 20-something years. So why do we do it? Well, the marriage ceremony has been an important feature across nearly every culture, religion, generation, and society. We have thousands of important moments that happen throughout our lives, but this one is regarded as being so critical that we acknowledge its special status by sharing it with others. And why this moment? Because, despite all our differences, love is what we all share. It's the great unifier, our one universal truth. No matter who we are, where we've come from, what we believe, we know this one thing, love is what we're doing right. And that's why Andrea and Dan are both standing here, and that's why you're all here to watch them stand up here. We've all loved in our lifetimes, and in this moment, we're reminded that the ability to love is the very best part of our humanity. Now, all of us here today have our own love stories. Some are short, others are long, some are yet unwritten, while others, they're just getting to the good parts. So I want to ask you now, how many of you know the story of how these two first became a couple? Anybody? And let's go a little bit further with that. How many of you know the truth? Okay, how many of you would like to know what I am told is supposed to be the truth? Well, Dan and Andrea met while in high school in North Bay through mutual friends and started to date in time for her senior year, which was also Dan's junior year. However, after a year of dating, it was time for her to pack up and move to Ottawa to attend university. To be clear, in the beginning, neither of them held high expectations for the longevity of their budding romance. And you know how it goes with high school relationships. So they sat down to have the big breakup talk. It failed. Instead, they kept on a long-distance relationship, and then Dan joined her in Ottawa the following year. In the end, the two completed their education despite hitting roadblocks, speed bumps, getting lost, and taking detours along the way. In that time, they had moved in together, adopted two cats, Mishka and Chelsea, moved again, and adopted a third cat, Rolo. They bought a car. They bought a car and shortly afterwards moved a third time to a garden home rental with a tiny backyard. A car and a backyard. These two things were Dan's requirements for the next step in the relationship, getting a dog. They adopted Winston, which was a big change for the couple's lifestyle. They now took daily walks in the afternoon to cap off their day and just talk with each other. On these innumerable walks, the couple would talk about their future together and dream big. They agreed to make it official and got engaged in December of 2018. It was on another such walk that they spotted a for sale sign and they decided to start shopping for a house together. They were too late for that specific house, but had kicked off what would become a whirlwind of home showings, offers, disappointments, and finally success. Within 2 months, they became homeowners, which was both exhilarating and terrifying. The little family settled into their new home in Barrhaven. The transition has come with its own sets of challenges, as neither Dan or Andrea consider themselves handy, and she has a knack for breaking things. Despite those small inconveniences, the pets are very happy with the upgrade. The cats love all the extra space, the big windows, and the ample sunbathing spots. And Winston is king of his backyard domain. Then as the pandemic started, they installed garden beds. The next year they expanded, planted strawberries. This year they slowed down a bit, but they got to enjoy a bountiful harvest of strawberries. Now together, they're learning how to garden. They're learning what they like to grow. They're learning how to fend off pests. And Winston helps in that regard. But they both get to spend a little more time appreciating nature and each other thanks to the effort they put into the garden together. In that time, their original wedding date, because there have been many, came and went. Each postponement was its own little heartbreak and a difficult decision to make. But every time they faced the dilemma, they made it together. And they were secure in the knowledge that they'd make it here someday in front of family and friends to make public the commitment, and to celebrate their love. So they stand before you, ready to begin a new and wonderful future together, all the while continuing to love, support, learn from, and lean on one another. And that, I am told, is supposed to be the truth. Is that your story? Are you sticking to it? So now I'm going to share with you a reading that they have selected, and it's called All I Know About Love. This is everything I have to tell you about love. Nothing. This is everything I've learned about marriage. Nothing. Only that the world out there is complicated, and there are beasts in the night, and delight and pain, and the only thing that makes it okay sometimes is to reach out a hand in the darkness and find another hand to squeeze and not be alone. It's not the kisses and never the kisses. It's what they mean. Somebody's got your back. Somebody knows your worst self and somehow doesn't want to rescue you or send for the army to rescue you. It's not two broken halves becoming one. It's the light from a distant lighthouse bringing you both safely home, because home is wherever you both are together. So this is everything I have to tell you about love and marriage. Nothing. Like a book without pages or a forest without trees, because there are things you cannot know before you experience them. Because no study can prepare you for the joys or the trials. Because no one else's love, no one else's marriage is like yours. And it's a road you can only learn by walking it, a dance you cannot be taught, a song that did not exist before you began together to sing. And because in the darkness you'll reach out a hand, not knowing for certain if someone else is even there, and your hands will meet, and then neither of you will ever need to be alone again. And that's all I know about love. So now we come to the expression of the intent. This is where we found out if Andrea and Dan really, really want to go through with this ceremony. So are you both ready to enter into this marriage, believing the love you share and your faith in each other will endure all things? Just yes. Say yes.
Yes.
Dan, you've chosen Andrea to be your wife. Will you love and respect her? Will you be honest with her always and stand by her through whatever may come?
Yes, I do.
Andrea, you've chosen Dan to be your husband. Will you love and respect him? Will you be honest with him always and stand by him through whatever may come?
Yes, I will.
Dan, will you accept that napping is a real form of time travel and that Andrea will not always stay awake on long car trips? In fact, she'll probably fall asleep within the first hour.
I do, and I reserve the right to listen to boring podcasts when she does.
Andrea, will you grant Dan more garden beds to use as he likes, as he gets more interested in gardening?
Yes. It might not be 50-50, and please plant something other than tomatoes.
Dan, will you support Andrea through her moments of temporary forgetfulness and blindness by helping her find her phone, her glasses, or both, which she swears she had a minute ago and which may still be in her hand or on her head or in a completely random place?
Yes, I will, but I will remind her to check the couch, her coat, the car, and her purse.
Andrea, will you accept that any grocery list you prepare for Dan will inevitably get left behind on the fridge, counter, or stairs? And Dan will assure you that it's fine and it's all up here. Yeah, but that's something else that will get forgotten.
I will, and when you call, because you can't remember what's on the list, I will go find it for you and read it to you.
Okay.
Dan, will you expect Andrea prefers to shop online, which means the living room often looks more like a box fort?
I will, so long as she cleans up after herself after the cats are done with it.
Andrea, will you tolerate Dan's need to organize to-do lists, chores, appointments, meetings, phone calls into 2-3 different apps and a Kanban board, and that there is a correct way to remove a sticky note from the top of a stack such that it doesn't curl?
I will, and I understand that Dan has an opinion on how to remove post-it notes, but I'm going to freestyle it.
Dan, will you continue to show your love to Andrea by helping her fall asleep at night by way of head pets?
I will, but as soon as she starts snoring, I'm going to reserve the right to look at videos, watch my silliness, and try not to laugh too hard and wake her up.
Andrea, will you respect that Dan genuinely enjoys loudly watching political debate, both Canadian and American, and probably others too, and that he will make an evening out of it?
I will, so long as he pours me a glass of wine and understands that I might not be as interested in it as he is.
Dan, will you acknowledge and accept that Andrea is a cat person and that your future with her contains an unknowable and indeterminate number of cats, and that your home, furniture, and clothing will always have some amount of cat hair?
I will, and over the years, I've learned how to deal with it.
Andrea, will you support Dan's need to host Dungeons and Dragons sessions, to keep an excessive collection of dice, miniatures, books, and other paraphernalia, while allowing him also to order more, to let him test out the weird goblin voices at you, and to let him vent when he's stressed that he hasn't prepared enough before his session, which apparently is every time?
I will, and we already have a couple conditions, which is I get takeout on game nights. In addition, new dice entering the home should come from Christine.
Okay, thank you.
Now, I did promise you a surprise skill testing question. Do you promise to love each other longer than it will take the Toronto Maple Leafs ever win the Stanley Cup again?
I do.
Excellent choice. Only been 55 years and many more to come. So now, in the spirit of joy and affirmation, I want to ask your families and friends for their support. You, the families and friends of Dan and Andrea, wishing them a wonderful life together. Do you give them your blessing and support and maybe the occasional bottle or two of really, really good wine? So now we come to your vows, and the symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know, all those things we promised and hoped and dreamt, well, I meant it, every word of it. Now, you'll say a few words that take you across the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you'll say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. And now I'm going to pass to you the vows that you've prepared. Andrea, here's yours, and there's yours, Dan, and you get to go first.
You know that we wrote this last night. Yeah, 2 years, you think we'd be a little bit more prepared? Okay. Hi. Dan, as I'm writing these personal vows to you, I have trouble finding the right words. I like to think that I tell you I love you often, every day even, but we both know this usually comes out as something that doesn't translate well for a wedding ceremony. A terrible joke, badly attempted attempts at tickling, or a high-pitched squeal of excitement. So although I'm attempting to express myself in full sentences, mostly for the benefit of our guests, know that these words will never be enough to cover it all.
Thank you. Andrea, 17 years ago, we started dating, and you fastly became my best friend. Over this time, we navigated high school together, struggled through university, moved in together, adopted animals, and worked together to establish our careers. You've been a reliable and caring partner who has always pushed me to improve and become the man I am today.
Okay. To me, being with you has never felt like a difficult thing to do. You are so easy to love. Hang on. And you let me express it to you in all of my weird and awkward and hyper ways. That said, it's not as if our relationship hasn't already faced our share of stressors, but each time we talked it out, made a plan together, and we made it through those hard times and grew the closer for it.
Andrea, you have an adventurous spirit and always challenge me to try new things and new activities, like Olympic weightlifting, gardening, ballroom dancing, and soon travel abroad. Occasionally, I like these activities so much, I make them my own. You are intelligent and care so much about what we do and how we do it. You're always looking out for our best interests and are always ready to catch any details that I might miss, and you make me my very best.
Okay. Thank you. Yep.
Okay. Yep, that's all I got.
It wasn't supposed to be me. It was supposed to be him. Okay. What I love about you. There are so many reasons I love you. The first thing that comes to mind is your calming energy, assuming you aren't teasing me. Even our pets love you more than they love me. because you're so stable and comforting. When I get overwhelmed, you give me a hug and a kiss and help to calm me down. Or Kleenex. I also love that you're a dog person. With you, we have Winston, which has allowed me to know the joy of having a dog. And that has allowed us more quality time and outdoor time with our daily walks and talks. And despite being a dog person, you still also make a great cat dad. I love that you are willing to try new things, be it new cuisines, growing out your hair, yeah, dance lessons, or choosing to wear a kilt on your wedding day. I love your openness to new ideas and experiences, that I get to be right there with you to enjoy them with you.
Andrea, I love the way you look at me, the way you smile when I get you to laugh, that you can't hide when you get excited or really happy. You instinctively rub your face like a gerbil, as you call it. I love your witty banter, your sarcastic jokes, and how you'll humor my need to discuss and debate complicated issues, ideas, everything and everyone. I love that you want to make me a better man, and that you do, and that I learn new skills and get to set new goals to ever be a reliable, loving partner for you.
So, Dan, I promise that from today, you will never face this world alone. I want to face the challenges of life, great and small, good and bad, at your side, as your partner and loving wife. If you reach out your hand, you'll always find mine. I promise to remember and appreciate and to show appreciation for all that you do, the effort and hard work that you put into us. I'm so lucky that you love me, and I never want to take your love for granted. I promise to respect you always. I promise to grow with you and to learn from you. I don't expect us to stay the same people we are today. Rather, that we will surely change over time. I promise to love and support the man you are today, the husband you'll be tomorrow, and the person you hope to become.
Andrea, I promise to be your bridge over the troubling waters of life. When you are down, I promise to carry you across to a place of peace. I promise to encourage and inspire you, to laugh with you, occasionally at you when it's warranted. I'll choose to love you every day, in word and in deed, to do the hard work of making now into always, to take your advice to heart and to listen, even when I'm not in the mood to, and I'll even try to remember to let you know that you were right in the end, to be present and to make an effort every day, for when we both support each other, we are capable of even greater things and will grow even stronger both as lovers and as people.
Today I feel like we've reached a milestone, and I'm so happy to be marrying you and beginning a new phase of our lives together, our next adventure. Just recently, we got our passports. And we're going on our honeymoon trip, and that's our newest adventure together. But I know that when we come home, our adventure will continue. We have our house together, we have our pets, we have our hopes and dreams, our some days, and our eventualies. And while I don't know exactly what the future holds for us, I can't help but feel it deep in my heart that it will be wonderful, because you will be at my side. I've known you for 17 years, and yet I still haven't had enough of you. Even though sometimes I have enough of you. I know that what I want is forever with you.
You're supposed to wait for that.
No.
Andrea, tomorrow we'll start a new phase in our lives as a married couple. As your husband, I'm looking forward to continue building out our home and family together. I'll continue to seek out family recipes for that cookbook I'm definitely working on, so our family will be able to inherit all of our older traditions and as well combine them to make new and exciting ones. I'll continue to study French and become fluent in it. Not really for the benefit of my career, though that's nice. But for the goal of nurturing any children we might have, to be French first within our home. Finally, I will embrace your need for adventure and will take you and our dog Winston on smaller hiking excursions to Gatineau Park, or pack our family and take us on larger adventures like a continental road trip or overseas vacations. We will always have new adventures on the next horizon.
Give him a hand for these awesome vows. Well done. So now we come to the exchange of rings, and I would invite the best man, Mark, to please prepare them. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual bond which unites two hearts in endless love. It's worn on the fourth finger because of an ancient Greek belief that a vein from that finger goes directly to the heart. And now that we've found the rings, if you would if you would bring them forward, Mark. So, Dan, as you offer this ring, please repeat after me. Andrea, I give you this ring.
Andrea, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment.
As a symbol of my commitment.
And our partnership in life.
And our partnership in life.
I promise to accept you for who you are.
I promise to accept you for who you are.
You have my heart always.
And you have my heart always.
And slide the ring on. Okay, done. Okay. Your turn, Andrea. Okay. Dan, I give you this ring.
Dan, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment.
As a symbol of my commitment.
And our partnership in life.
And our partnership in life.
I promise to accept you for who you are.
I promise to accept you for who you are.
With or without a beard.
With or without a beard.
You have my heart always.
Have my heart always.
And slide the ring on.
And slide the ring on.
And now, Dan, if you take her engagement ring, this ring is a symbol of promise and intent. Now the intention is realized and the promise fulfilled. So please place this ring above her wedding band to symbolize that the love that brought you together will always protect and sustain your marriage. So now I'm going to ask you to face each other, hold your hands, palms up, so that you can see the gift they are to you. You've promised to walk the path of life together, hand in hand. Now as you stand here at the beginning of this journey, remember, these are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children and support your grandchildren. These are the hands that will wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, and as today, tears of joy. These are the hands that will keep you together for every step of your walk through life together. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. And may you see your four hands as healer, protector, shelter, and guide. So, Andrea, Dan, we all know that your visions of the future are not identical, but always complementary. Walt Disney once said that all our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them. Nelson Mandela reflected that a winner is a dreamer who never gives up. John Lennon also observed, a dream you dream alone, it's only a dream, but a dream you dream together, that is reality. And for you, that reality officially starts now, even though we all know it really started quite some time ago. So go and continue to live your dream. You've expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises that you've just made. It's with these in mind that by the powers vested in me, by the province of Ontario, I now pronounce you husband and wife, and you may now seal your vows with a
kiss.
It is.